Let's learn about conditional statements in Python. And before we do that, let's understand what a statement is. A statement is an instruction in a program. We understand that a program is a set of instructions. And to write these instructions, we must write statements that are provided by a particular programming language. Statements of a particular programming language can be executed in three ways. Or there are three types of statements. First, sequence. This means we write the statements which are executed one after the other. Second is conditional, where the set of statements that are selected to be executed depends upon a condition. Thus, they are also called as selection statements. For example, you wish to write a temperature conversion program where you want to convert temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit as well as from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Then you would write two sets of statements, one belonging to this category, Celsius to Fahrenheit, second belonging to Fahrenheit to Celsius category. But which set of statements you would execute would depend upon the choice that is given by the user. Third set of statements are iteration, where we write the statements which are repeatedly executed. In Python, we write conditional statements by using if statement. We write if followed by a condition. This condition is an expression that would either get evaluated to Boolean value true or get evaluated to Boolean value false. If the condition evaluates to true, then the statements that we write here in this section gets executed. If the Boolean value evaluates to false, then we come in the else section and the statements that are written here in this section get executed. So, we put the condition. Condition can give me the answer as yes or condition can give me the answer as no. And based on the answer, we decide which set of statements to execute. Also note the placement of colon after the condition and here after else. One more thing to note is that these statements that you write should be little indented inside. And finally, the else section that you write is completely optional. So let's look at this program here. We have x which is taken from the user as an integer number and we are checking if x is greater than 0. If it is so, we print positive number. So let's execute this program by saying run module. And we give some number like 10 and it gives me the answer as positive number. But this program, when it takes a negative number, is not doing anything. That is, when minus 5, let's say, is entered for x, minus 5 greater than 0 is false. And when the condition is false, we simply do not execute this. That's it. But here in the program, there is nothing specified as to what has to be done when the number is negative. So let's execute this. When I enter minus 5, we just get the shell prompt back. So now if I also want to print that the number is negative, then in that case, I can specify else and here I can print negative number. So now when I execute this program, I enter a positive number, it gives me the answer correctly. I execute it one more time. And then I enter minus 5, that also I get correctly. And now let's say I execute it third time and I enter 0, it gives me the answer as negative number, which looks incorrect. The reason that it has happened is because we are not catering for 0. Suppose x value is 0, 0 greater than 0 is false. And therefore we come in the else part and for 0 we are simply printing negative number. So now let's modify this program to take care of 0 also. For this, we need to understand that x greater than 0 when this condition is false, then there are two possibilities more which we have to check. That is, if x is not greater than 0, then x can be less than 0 or x can be equal to 0. So we come in the else part when x is not greater than 0, and here we need to check for two more possibilities. So we check x is less than 0, and only when this condition is true we print negative number. If I come here now in the else section, then only possibility that I am left with is that x is 0. So now when I run this program and I enter a value as 0, it gives me value 0. So what we have done here is we have added another possibility that we were missing out in the previous program, and that we have done by putting one more if inside the inside another if. So this one more if that you see here is the inner if, which has gone inside the outer if. Such an if structure where you see one if inside another if is called as nesting of if. Now nesting of if can be written inside else section. It can also be written inside if section. So let's look at that alternative also. So here let me modify this program. We write if x greater than or equal to 0. Now when this happens, x greater than or equal to 0 will be true in two conditions. One is when x is greater than 0, and second is when x is equal to 0. So now when I am here at that, wherever the cursor is, at this place there are two possibilities. So for that we write one more if x greater than 0. If that is so, we print positive number. If I come here in the else section, then in that case there is only one possibility, that is print 0. And if I come in the else section of the outer if, then there is only one possibility, that the number is negative. And we can remove this. So now if x is positive, then in that case x greater than or equal to 0 is true. We come here, we check x is greater than 0, that is also true, we print positive number. If x is a negative number, then x greater than or equal to 0 is false. We directly come here and we print a negative number. If x is equal to 0, then x greater than or equal to 0 is true. We come inside this condition, x greater than 0 is false for 0. So we come in the else section and we print 0. So things to note. First is that else is optional anywhere you are writing if. Second is that if structure can be nested. And third is nesting can be done in the if part or in the else part. Now there is a better way of doing this nesting in Python by using if, elif, else structure. So we write if, elif like this. We write if, we put condition 1. And if this condition 1 is true, we execute some statements. If this condition 1 is false, then we come to elif. And in elif, we can put another condition. If this condition is true, we execute the statements. If it is false, we go to the third elif. We can write as many elifs as we want. And optionally, we can put an else statement. So let's see by using such a structure, how we can improvise this program. So now we have x which is coming from the user, and here we put x greater than 0. So if x is greater than 0, then we can print positive number. And then we put elif. So next condition that I want to check is x is less than 0. And then here we print and then we can write else, because if x is not greater than 0 we come here, If x is not less than 0 also, then we come here. And now only one possibility that is left with us is that it is 0. So this looks much better in structure, as well as it increases the readability of the program. So now when I execute this, enter a number 10, it gives me positive. One more time I run. If I enter minus 5, it gives me negative. One more time I run and I enter 0, it gives me 0. Okay. The next way to put a condition is by using an expression, which is called as a conditional expression. So here you see a simple program where x is taken as input, and on this side here you see an expression. Okay, this expression that you see is called as conditional expression. So it says that value of y can be positive. Value of y will be positive if this condition is true. Otherwise, that is else, the value of y will be negative. Or the value of expression will be positive if x greater than 0, else the expression would evaluate to negative. And then we print y. The output of this program is also going to be the same. That is, when x is 10, 10 greater than 0 will be true, and therefore the expression evaluates to positive. That would become the value of y. If the x value is minus 5, then in that case, the x condition will be false. The expression would evaluate to negative, and in that case y value will be negative. And we print either positive or negative. Now this flaw of not recognizing 0 as 0 is still there in this program. So if I enter 0 as the value of x, 0 greater than 0 is false, and therefore negative will be the value of y. So now for that, in conditional expression also, we can provide the nesting. So now let's look at this expression here. It says if x is greater than 0, if this condition is true, the expression evaluates to positive. Else, here we put one more if. If x is less than 0 and if this condition is true, then the expression evaluates to negative. Otherwise, the expression evaluates to 0. So now if I give the value of x as 0, then in that case 0 greater than 0 is false. So it will come in the else part. In the else part there is one more if. So 0 less than 0 is also false. Therefore 0 would be the value of y. If the number is negative, let's say minus 4, then in that case x greater than 0, minus 4 greater than 0 is false. Therefore, it will come here, minus 4 less than 0 is true. Therefore, negative will become the value of y. And finally, when x value is something like 10, then 10 greater than 0 is true. Therefore, positive will be the value of y.